in all of the scripture. And so do we just need to write a new one, Evan? You're our most recent Masters of Divinity, Master yeah. Evan here, just graduated with that in a few months ago. And so do we need to go through and take the Bible and put more modern, let's take those illustrations, those things that are very culturally based, let's take them out of there and put something else in there so that anybody can read the Bible and it make perfect sense to them?
No, we shouldn't. David? there are people that are actually trying to do that. Like you see, I think I saw somebody, I'm going to missay it. Somebody trying to do the Bible in like emojis or someone trying to do a biblical interpretation that all has like bro speak, like surfer dude speak, right? You know, and it's silly. It was in the premise of your question, I think, but if we believe the Bible is inerrant, infallible, then God wrote it during a specific time in a specific way for a specific reason, and it's still a living text, so it can speak to us that way. Is it harder? Yeah. And maybe it's meant to be. Maybe we're supposed to work a little harder. Those people didn't have... it was all verbal tradition, so they didn't have their own copies, so they were hearing it and passing those stories on. We have the ability to read it. Like David said, we have so many resources open to us that make it, you got to make sure you get good resources, but because there are bad resources too, but we have so much opportunity. We just have to work at it, and I think God wants us to work at understanding Him and knowing Him better.
Youth leader, would you like to have a dumbed down version of the Bible that does away with all of those contextualized truths and speaks a language that a modern youth could read, the emoji Bible, that a modern youth could read and go, oh, there's the simple truth?
No, I do not think that I would have one of those, but... my reasoning would be, I guess, a little different in my explanation for youth standpoint, would be that just because it's difficult doesn't mean we shouldn't try to learn it. That is part of working through our faith, is going through the difficult times of studying Scripture and what it convicts us of and what it shows us. And a lot of times I think that people read things or see things, especially in Scripture, and it's not just teenagers, it's adults too, and they read through a passage and they go, well, I didn't understand three of the words that were in there, and they're probably important, but I'm not going to look it up, and I'm just going to keep going. And like I said, we have the ability to figure out basically what anything is. In a matter of 30 seconds, if you tell me a word in a scripture, we can pull up our phone or the internet, and we can go, well, what Greek word did they use, or Hebrew word? And we can find out what the literal word used in the text was, and we can maybe get just a little more meaning of maybe what that meant when they said this word. And when we dumb it down, like you said, I think we cheapen it. I think that we lose a little bit. We don't make it have the same weight. We don't give it it doesn't have the same value, in my opinion. And so in my opinion, when I'm teaching a class with the teenagers and we're studying something from Timothy or wherever, it's my job as the teacher or as a parent at home, whoever I am, my job is to understand that as best as I can, and then take my child or my teenager who's not necessarily capable of getting there themselves, and I dumb it down for them in our own words so that we can have that discussion, rather than them just getting an easy way out with a quick to read Bible that says love each other and then that's the end of the Bible. You know, it'd be so simple if you tried to make a simple version.
Oh, I'm sorry. I really wanted to say something.
No, go ahead.
To what he said. I remember the thing he said about teaching is so true, because I remember the first English teacher that made me love Shakespeare. Like, we had to read it, and they told us to read on it. And so I read it, and I'm like, this is dumb. And then the next day, she was like, did y'all like that sword fight? And there's, like, murder and sex and all this stuff. And I was like, I didn't even realize all this stuff was in there. And so I'm not comparing the Bible to Shakespeare, but that's how a good teacher can open up what even a difficult text is. for you.
So really, we don't need to change the Bible. And I think that's a great conclusion to that. Now, I'm gonna commit blasphemy here. Greatest movie of all time, in my opinion, is The Princess Bride. And the thing that I've loved about
inconceivable to me. Sorry.
The thing that I've loved about that movie is I've probably watched it close to 100 times with no exaggeration. And it's been a while, but well into the 50th time that I watched it, I saw things that I went, whoa, that ties to there. And when you're going to be handed one book and told, study this for your lifetime, not only that, take everything you've learned, pass it to your children and challenge them to study it for their lifetime. You can't give them a simple book. It has to have layers to it that every time I've read the Bible through every year with 1 year exception since I was 20 years old. And some of those years I read it through twice because of different studies going on. But with 1 year exception, every year since I was 20, I've read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. And I still find stuff that I go, hey, do you guys realize that Noah knew a guy that spent a lot of time with a guy who spent a lot of time with Adam, and Adam walked in the garden with God. So Noah's really only one dude removed from walking in the garden with God. But he lived so far away that, I mean, that was only a few years ago that realization clicked for me. And I think we have to leave the layers in because God's not going to send us another one. So he hides all of the truths, all of the mysteries, layered upon layered upon layered within the story that we have. And so while we don't get a new book, if we will take the time to look, we'll find a new story in that story. And so what are the best ways to encourage somebody